In many cases, the programmer may wish to call subroutines which are created by other programmers. And so the assembler will create an object file for each of the different source files. And this each individual output file will not be a complete object program, because each source file could have references to other object files or other source files. And so these external references have to be resolved. Source file 1 might have an external reference to or call some procedure in source file 2. Source file 2 may have some external reference to source file 3, and so on. So the assembler is creating an object file for each of the source files. Alongside that, the assembler will identify the external references and build a list of names and the instructions that refer to them, and it will include these external references in this object file. The task of the linker is to combine all these object files into one object program. So in doing this, it has to resolve these external references, and so it needs the relative positions of the address labels. And for references within the object module, it needs the length of the object module also. So all of this information the assembler provides to the linker in the header of the object file. Let us take a look at an example. So I have four object modules over here. This is object module A, whose length is 400. This object module, the length is 600. Object module C, length is 500. Object module D, length is 300. Each of the object module is starting at an address 0. Okay, this is the base address for each object module. This is a reference address, or you can say it's a reference counter. Here you see at address 0, it says branch to 200. So this 200 is a reference to this address 200 from the base. So there is one instruction over here. There are other instructions here. At 300 address, this 300 is from the base address again. At 300, there is an instruction which says call B. This is an external reference problem, because the address of B is not known over here. So when the assembler will create the object file for this, the address of this module B will be unresolved. Similarly, you can see that there is an external reference problem over here, which is C. It is calling module C. This module C is calling module D, and so on. In each of the modules, whenever it says branch to 300, it is referring to the displacement of that address from the base address. So let us see now what the linker will do. The linker will take each of these object modules into the memory and stack them one on top of the other to create a single object module, to create a single image. Suppose, for example, when these modules are taken to the memory, to the RAM, by the linker, suppose the first module starts at memory address 100. Now, this is the actual physical address. So the first module, object module A, starts at address 100. There was a instruction in module A which had set branch to 200, which was the offset from the base address of A. Now this address will change. As you can see, the 200, the address, the instruction at this address 200. So this address has changed to 300 because of the relocation of object module A. So for each module, we should be knowing its relocation constant. And that is the address at which its new module in the memory image is beginning. Like for example, in this we see that the relocation constant for object module A is 100. So any internal references, we will have to add 100 to this. So now this should actually be branch to 300, as you can see over here. What will be the relocation constant of module B? The relocation constant of module B will be the starting address of module A plus the length of module A. So module A length was 400. So from 100 to 499, module A will be existing. From 500, module B would start. So the relocation constant for module B would be 500, because that is the starting address of module B, and that has to be taken care of in this particular offset. For module C, since the length of the object module was 600, so 600 has to be added to the base address of module B to get the relocation constant of module C, and this is 1100. This has to be added here. Similarly, for D, the relocation constant would be the relocation constant of C, which is 1100, plus the length of this module, which is 500. So the relocation constant for D would become 1600. Apart from taking care of the internal references and the internal offsets in the branch instructions, there are some external references which need to be resolved, like this call for B. So now B starts at 500. So B can be replaced by 500. C can be replaced by 1100, which is the starting address of object module C. And D can be replaced by 1600, which is the starting address of object module D. Here you can see all the changes that have been taken care of. So the internal references for the branch offsets and the call to the new modules, they have been taken care of in the new image that has been created by the linker. And this final image is ready. Now there is a possibility that when this executable file is stored onto the disk and when it is brought again to the memory, it is not necessary that it will be brought to memory address 100 again. So if that happens, again all the relocation constants and the external references that were put into the image might not work. So if the object, the final executable file, would be brought into the memory at the same address every time, then this image will work. Otherwise, this has to be kept in an unresolved state, and the absolute addresses have to be resolved when the image is brought into the memory. when this complete executable is brought into the memory, then depending upon the physical address in the memory where that image is put, the final linking of the addresses takes place. The final binding of the absolute addresses takes place at the load time. So the loader will pick up this executable from the disk and bring it to the memory. And if there are any unresolved addresses, it will resolve at that particular time. Also, there are many subroutines written for one application program, which may be useful for other application programs also. So all such object files which are containing such routines are put into a library file and stored on the disk. So this library can also be linked to any application program while creating the executable file. This could be done while creating the executable file or while executing the program also, which is called dynamic linking. So the library file will be linked to this executable file only when the program is being executed. And then a single copy of the library can be shared by multiple application programs.